Welcome to e-Pathashala. We are now going to talk about Larsen & Toubro port at Kattupalli, around 40 kilometers away from north of Chennai city. This particular place is very, very interesting in terms of landscaping, and it's a very big challenge for you to do it, mainly because the entire soil has been dumped here from the seabed. I mean, it is basically a sea sand, real sea sand, not that what you see sea sand outside the beach or anything. It is not that. It has been pumped from the water and then poured into the level, and they have almost around 2,000 acres of land, and you have to develop it as a garden. It was a very big challenge for us. Even you don't get a good water here. Drinking water is one of the biggest problems here, because as you know very well that anywhere very near the sea you will get a good water, whereas here getting a water is the biggest challenge, and then using the water, and the people are also very, very unfriendly here. Fishermen folks, as you know, they are all a little bit violent, and their lands have been used by these people for developing the port, so they are angry with the people. And they are all not bothered about any kind of civilization. Thefts are going to jail or fighting with the policeman. It's a very normal thing for them. Whereas, you know, as a person like us, you will find it very difficult to cope up with those kind of situations. And people will come overnight and they steal away your motor, your thing, everything, and they only lie. They want to make only money, money, money. It's very difficult. But with these challenges, we have given a very good solution for the Kattupalli port. We had four port shipyards, and then one more industrial area was there where they manufacture these triangular fins for the breakwater, construction of breakwaters. So our main aim is the main road, Avenue Tree Plantation. Then other areas where you have to plant lot of casuarina as a group to protect the instruments, other things from the salt spray. Of course, you need aesthetics and terms, you have to do the grassing. So how to achieve this? We have to have only imported soil has to be done. So the pit size is 3 by 3 by 3 feet. You have to dig up, fill up the entire area with the good soil and plant a tree. So over a period, you know, a tree will go only into that particular soil area and then grow on top of it. So that was one of the idea. And soil availability of soil is also a very big problem there. So we have to get almost 500 truckloads of soil in a very short span of time, and then dump it somewhere and then retransport it to different locations. It was a very, very mammoth job to handle. But end of the day, you know, the result was very good. So you, once you design, go through the design, you will understand what kind of an input was given in this project.
When we are talking about the landscaping of port area, what is more important is you will have lot of containers, lot of huge cranes, lot of machineries running around. So sometimes it may not be possible for you to have a avenue trees or anything like that. Plus you have lot of salt spray near the sea. You have lot of salt in the atmosphere. Plus it's a very, very rough weather, and most of the area has been reclaimed, and the most of the soil is from the sea itself. So you'll have only salt soil, beach sand, nothing will grow except seaweeds and things like that. So it's a very challenging project. How to decide about the planting plan of this zone? What plants can be used? How it can be used? And what are the implications of those planting? How are you going to improve the climatic condition after doing the plantation? Plus, how are you going to manage your circulation? Plus, how are you going to cater to the future needs of the fort development? So a lot of challenging aspects are there in this particular project. Even though the site extends to the area of around 1,000 odd acres, but you have a problem at your hand. the phase one development, phase two development, and things like that. Just now. See, what is more important? This is an industrial zone, and we have the following aspects as well. Okay, this is an area where industrial zone is located. We have earmarked some area for green belt, then roads and circulation is there, entry point is there, internal road is there, you have port area, commercial shipyard, housing, and things like that are there. So what is more important in analyzing the whole thing is what is basically required of the area, how best are you going to change the soil condition to make the plants grow in that area. So boundary is about 4.5 kilometers of length, compound wall is there, and moreover you have the problem of local population which is been removed from the area and then new housing provided for them, shifting of the people. And these fishermen folks are there, and you have lot of antisocial activities. You cannot blame them calling it as antisocial or anything. It's a question of their survival. So how are you going to react to that? Because it's their life, you know. You are grabbing the land from the fisherman folks and then building your shipyard. So what is required in that? So boundaries about, we talk about 4.5 kilometers, rich green belt with 3-tier planting created along the entire stretch with a view in providing necessary security arrangements. Then soil is sandy, so what kind of planting need to be done? All those things need to be taken into consideration. So we have some of the site photograph of this particular zone. You have seawall being created. You have breakwaters, you have groins, you have a lot of things, anti-sea activity, anti-ecological activity in order to sustain the industrial growth. So this is a growth aspect, so we cannot really blame anybody, or it's not a blame game. It's you're taking the land away from the sea, so what are you going to do? So this is the overall master plan. We have green belt shown along the boundary areas. So you can see that green area of 4.5 kilometers running across the compound wall as a green belt. Then you have external roads. The entry point is there. Then internal road entry point, this being the entry point. So main road leading into the first industrial area, the port, the shipyard area. This is a port area. Second area is shipyard area. Then commercial shipyard area. So we need to have a commercial activity taking place. Then you have a residential area. You have MFF, that is again the sustenance of your groins and other thing. They manufacture those pins, you know, which are used for the purpose of your sea groins or breakwaters. So this is the overall plan now, master plan is prepared. Have the oranges MFF, the residential area in the southwest corner. Then you have the natural lagoons are there which need to be conserved, and then your shipyard and port area is there. So we are talking about a green belt. What is required of a green belt? You have 2 tiers of tall growing trees, then 2 levels of medium trees are planted with a low level sand filling, and then you have a local grass, seaweed grass grown on the lower level so that sand erosion may not take place because of the high wind velocity of this area. Then you have, next one is road landscaping, what need to be done on the roads, external roads you have. Have entrance area is there. Have internal roads are there. Then how the road need to be landscaped. What is more important? You have Buckingham Canal on the other side. You have this being the main entrance area. You need to have a proper landscaped road in order to show the importance of this particular road. And the importance of this particular port also, you need to have a very rich landscaping on this area. So this is the kind of development we need to take place. You have a trees of paradise trees are there, Terminalia Kadapa is there, then neem trees are planted. Basically, we would like to plant local trees so that, you know, it doesn't have a problem in growth, because we are trying to grow them in a very, very difficult environmental situation. Then you have Terminalia Kadapa, Paradise, Swetinia Mahogany, Nerium Oleander. All these are very hardy trees which can be planted in this zone. Then Canophyllum, Minophyllum, we call it Nunamaram in local language. Guaiacum sanctum also is a local tree. Both are local tree which can be planted. Along with Casuarina belt, so that, you know, the Casuarina act as a filter for your salt spray. Again, Casuarina, the typical Casuarina erosion prevention general as a windbreaking element. We have a lot of industrial building coming up there. Industrial buildings coming up there, we need to protect the buildings from high wind and cyclonic activities, so that these Casuarina will act as a windbreaker or shelter belt or controlling the wind speed. Then we have Kaigelia pinnata is a local variety, Thabubia avellanida local variety, Cassia javanica, Acacia auriculiformis, Cassia fistula. These are all the different trees which can be planted in order to give a character to this particular area. Thabubia avellanida. I think you can read about whatever I have given this particular tree. How the trunks, leaves, flowers, how the avenue looks when you plant Cassia. Kaigelia pinnata. Cassia javanica. Cassia fistula. Beautiful tree. It's called as Indian laburnum as a common name. Got an Indian name towards it. And it's a very good flowering tree. During flower, it flowers extensively yellow color. These flowers are used for puja purpose by Kerala, and it blooms exactly in coincidence with the Kerala New Year Day. And what kind of shrubs we can plant? We can go in for very hardy varieties. Axora hedge, Clerodendron, Bougainvillea hedge, Nerium Oleander. And we have Legostomia species, Bahunia, some royal palms to give a character to that area. These are the different kind of plant can happen along the external roads. Then shrubs like Euphorbia mellii, Nerium oleander, Clerodendron, Pedilanthus. Pedilanthus is a particular plant, even though it looks ugly or anything, it's a tree which normally doesn't eaten by the cattle. These areas we have a lot of cattle problem is also there. So we have to have planting which will not be attracted by the cattle. Pedilanthus written about, you can read them. Euphorbia mellii, a bit of thorny plant, good flowering. Nerium oleander, Bougainvillea, very colorful plant, this particular plant. If you stop watering, you know, it flowers profusely. So you can use the color in a very effective form. Then green belt on the southern side, how to, what kind of plants we can plant on there? Green belt, Canophyllum, Minophyllum, Hibiscus Tritalis, Terminalia, Kadapa, Paradise Tree, Guaicum Sanctum, Cassia Spectabilis. These are all the trees which can be planted on the green belt area. See, what is necessary of a green belt is it should also act as a very good buffer for the outside people not to see what is happening inside. Otherwise, you know, we have a lot of antisocial activity. People can jump into the compound wall and come inside, steal something or spoil something and go. So we have to prevent them entering the campus. These are all the dense foliage plant which will not show you what is happening inside. Canophyllum, Minophyllum, call it Punnai Maram in Tamil. Hibiscus Tritalis, wild cotton tree. Cassia Spectabilis, flowers, leaves, Terminalia Kadapa. It's a badam tree actually. Guaicum Sanctum. It's all very hardy trees. It can be used in a second, first tier, something like that, so that it will block the view of the taller trees. Lesser canopy height. Simuroga Gluaca, Paradise Tree. These are all become now localized tree, even though you have a origin of Florida or anything, but this grows very well in our climate. Canarpus Ectria, Thevitia, Swetinia Magangani, Nerium Oriander. See, we cannot have same uniform tree all around 4.5 kilometers. You have to create some kind of an aesthetic effect. So you have to keep changing the varieties in order to achieve a landscape character of that area. So that's why, you know, you have different variety. Canocarpus erectus, can read what is there about this particular tree. Thevitia, flowers. Actually, this was called originally in Tamil as Arali tree. The pods are used by women to scare the men folks by eating them as a poison. Swetinia Magangani, very good wood value tree. But of course, it gives you wood only at the age of 40 or something like that. So now you can plant it more for the aesthetical value and then leaf, very greeny leaf tree. this particular tree, mahogany, is able to withstand very strong winds, and it's not easily, what you call it, we won't budge to the wind and break or anything. It's and moderately salts are tolerant also, this particular tree. Can read a lot of character about this particular tree. This is what we have proposed along the main entry point of the highway into the port area. Once you start planting like this, this will have a very good impact. So another view with your footpath and median planting. The entry area planting. You have wooded area as a buffer on both the sides. Then you have some water cascades, medians, public road, and then internal roads, avenue trees. It's all designed to have a grander entrance of this particular area. You can go through them in detail. So this is how it will look when things have completed. You need to have a very grand entrance. Flowering trees along the road avenue, we have Telonyx regia, Mania azadirachta, Thebubia avellanidae, Alistronia scholaris, Spathodia, Albizia lebec, Strachulia fortifida. These are the seven different varieties of trees we like to plant on the internal roads. So this is how it looks once it is developed. Have a large tree and a footpath and trucks moving spaces. Shipyard area, we are talking about the road landscaping, open space landscaping. So this is an administrative building is there, then you have a future admin block comes up. So what kind of landscaping you are doing? You have created some amphitheater in the corner. You have walking space all around the site. And you have a secluded car parking area for them. Then you have other amenities are there. Your kitchen, other facilities are there. You can go through them. This is how the overall pictures of the site will look like. These are all the trees which we have talked about earlier, Spathodia campaninata, Strachulias, Begonia megapotomica, Thebubia rosea, Cardia sebastiana, Bahunia. What is basically required in these areas, you have a dense foliage tree gives a shade on the road and on the parking area. You need a shade on the road because you cannot walk on the road with so much of scorching sun with the sea nearby. Dense foliage trees gives a shade on the building side area to reduce the temperature of the building. Group of trees with tall dense foliage located near the building area. Small trees with dense foliage that give shade for the pathway is also required because we along the pathway you need a human scale is required. Specimen branch with dense foliage for decorative purpose. We are talking about dense foliage everywhere mainly because dense foliage plant trees which will withstand the speed of the wind and it will not break. What is more important is you have to have a tree which can using dense foliage plant mainly because we don't want a fragile tree. We want to have a solid tree which can hold the wind speed up to 100-150 kilometers due to cyclonic activity. That's why we are talking about a dense foliage. So, and most of the trees we'd like to have a deciduous. What is deciduous? Semi-deciduous, not deciduous. So these are all, we are talking about the deciduous trees. So here you have lot of wind. So sand particle getting into the leaves are very common. So this sand particle, very fine one with the wind speed and other thing. Sorry. Yeah. We're talking about sand particle getting into the leaf. Sand particle getting into the finer porous of the leaves, you know, usually we know photosynthesis, tree is breathing. I don't think we have to teach you all about it. But these sand particle getting into the leaves and blocking the breathing or photosynthesis process of the tree. So when we have a deciduous tree, this leaf will keep falling over a period of time and new leaf will grow. So these new leaves will be able to take more dust and then the old tree will come to the ground and then all the sand water accumulated will come to the ground level. So this cycle, you know, will help the tree to grow in a better way than the evergreen trees. Of course, there is no evergreen tree as it is, but trees normally do fill leaves, but semi-deciduous trees are much better than that. Deciduous tree, total deciduous also will be a problem because you will not have shade when you really wanted it. So we have to have a combination of deciduous, evergreen, semi-deciduous trees need to be used in order to achieve a proper balance in the total ecological system. And these are all the palm variety. What kind of palms? Palms are normally planted in this area for vertical element importance, number one. Number two, normally palms do well on the coastal area. Number three, it also gives a very royal look to the site. So there are different types of palms we have. Royal palm is there, date palm is there, areca palm is there, foxtail palm, fishtail palm, a lot of variety. So all these varieties can be used as a focal point or an avenue formation or anything like that. And we are talking about shrubs and ground cover. Song of India we call it. Then lantana is there, then Nerium oleander is there, chlorophytum is there, hexora is there. These varieties, Rio discolor, plumbago, vedelia, Rafus excelsa, tabernum montana, opia pagan. See, all these varieties will add color to the landscaping. These will take care of the lower level of planting, more of a micro elements. Then commercial shipyard area, what need to be done there? We have central one lagoon is already there in the site. So what need to be done? We have amidst of lot of port activity, shipping activity, lot of commercial, lot of huge buildings and things like that. You need a breakaway space for the staff. So this will act as one of the very good breakaway space with a natural water body, with gazebos, tennis court, and then eating space. So all those things will give a kind of a relaxation for the workers and then officials, everybody. So we need to have some kind of a recreation along with your working. Then only you can have lot of work culture will happen. If you go to any Hyundai factory or anything like that, evening 4:30 you can see the MD level to the lower level comes out and start playing the game. For half an hour they all break out and then have a game played, then go back to the working. So these kind of little bit of activity, you know, will improve the production level of every staff member. So these are the things which we need to learn from others, and we need to do these kind of spaces also in the landscaping. Then you can also create a lot of casuarina grooves in the area. So these grooves, you know, will grow to a maturity level in 5 years period. And these grooves, you know, can be cut or can be done away with after 5 years with lot of commercial value on it. So now these grooves will become a nice, tomorrow some money will come. Economical aspect also can be taken care. This is a view of the walkway around the pond. Then we have housing area, what need to be done in the housing area. And with the swimming pool, typical housing area with kasirunagurus, walkways, and these people are coming all the way from the city and staying in the site area. So you can also give them a modern city environment so that, you know, people won't run away from here, and they also have a lot of activity for the kids, activity for everybody, which is more important to house them in a colony like this. So the views of the swimming pool. Seating galleries, some children's birthday party, things like that can act. See, landscaping nowadays, we have to think in terms of lot of activity-based landscaping rather than just a green area. These kind of amphitheater, you know, you have a birthday party, marriage function, or some cultural activity. So we have to have lot of things like that, then only, you know, people can live there happily. What is more important, their living environment only make them work for you. MFF, another area. So basically, lot of sheds. So what are we going to do? We just have to plant trees all along the shed for avenue formation. There's some kind of greenery around the buildings. So this is a smaller scale so that you can see little more greenery along the building. And trees on the sides of the roads so that, you know, you have some kind of an avenue. Otherwise, walking in this area with a high structure buildings will be very difficult.
The overall budget given to us was around 13 crores, and then 13 crores was designed by me, not overall budget given to me, but ultimately they had approved only to the tune of 4 crores. So 30% of the area only is being taken as a budget to develop this area. Since the soil is not there, since the water is not there, and very undue, unkind of an atmosphere, and too much of radiation heat because of the salt soil available all over the area. And more than that, you know, the plant growth and other things will have a lot of problems because you are not able to do the watering properly. You are not able to do a lot of things properly. And ultimately, end of the day, we were able to achieve some kind of thing with the proper choice of plant materials, proper choice of soil mix, and other things. Thank you.